Assalamu alaikum and very good morning, dear students. It's our fifth video lesson, which is second of this chapter, natural numbers and whole numbers. And today's topics are properties of four operations with natural and whole numbers. Dear students, please open your mathematics books, New Countdown, Book 6. By the end of this lesson, you should be able to apply properties of addition on natural numbers and whole numbers. Use properties of subtraction on natural numbers and whole numbers. Learn properties of multiplication on natural numbers and whole numbers. And apply properties of division on natural numbers and whole numbers. Now, first of all, properties of addition. Commutative property of addition states that sum of two natural or whole numbers remain unchanged if the numbers interchange their places. As if we write 15 plus 7, the answer is 22. And if we write 7 plus 15, the answer will remain 22. Now we will take some more examples. Now, 63 plus 92 is equals to 155. And if we interchange their places, 92 plus 63 is also 155. It means 63 plus 92 is equals to 92 plus 63. So 155 is equals to 155. Now commutative property of addition is proved. Associative property of addition states that the sum of three numbers remain unchanged if the order in which they grouped is altered or changed. We will see with the help of example. There are three numbers, 14, 25 and 12. And if we make association between 14 and 25, the answer is 39. And when we add 12 in it, the ultimate answer is 51. And here, if we make association between 25 and 12, its answer is 37, and when we add 14 in it, the answer will remain 51. Now you can see both the answers are same. It means associative property of addition is proved. Now properties of subtraction. If a natural or whole number is subtracted from another natural or whole number, the difference may not always be a natural or whole number. For example, we will subtract 24 from 38, the answer is 14. It means a natural or whole number is subtracted from a natural or whole number, the difference is a natural or whole number. But in other case, when we subtract 58 from 35, the answer is minus 23. Is it natural or whole number? No, it is not. Which type of number is this? Yes, exactly, it is an integer. So, a natural or whole number is subtracted from a natural or whole number. The difference is not a natural or whole number. The closure property does not apply to subtraction. Now, commutative property. We will see that it can be applied on subtraction or not. 25 minus 18 is equals to 7. And 18 minus 25 is equals to minus 7. So 25 minus 18 is not equals to 18 minus 25. So commutative property does not apply to subtraction. Now we will check with associative property. So 18 minus 12 is inside the bracket, then minus 8. The answer is 6 minus 8 and it is equals to minus 2. And we will make different group. So it is 18 minus, inside the bracket is 12 minus 8, so it is equals to 18 minus 4, and the answer is 14. So see, this answer is minus 2 and this answer is 14, so both are not equal. It means 18 minus 12 inside the bracket minus 8 is not equals to 18 minus inside the bracket 12 minus 8. So associative property does not apply to subtraction. Now, properties of multiplication. The closure property of multiplication states that the product of two whole or natural numbers is also a whole or natural number. For example, 24 multiplied by 2 is equals to 48. So all the three are natural numbers or whole numbers. It means the closure property is proved on multiplication. Now we will check on commutative property. 15 multiplied by 7 is equals to 105, and 7 multiplied by 15 is equals to 105. So it means 15 into 7 is equals to 7 into 15. So commutative property applies to multiplication. It is proved. Now we will check on associative property. So 8 multiplied by 7 inside the bracket multiplied by 2. It is equals to 56 multiplied by 2, and the answer is 112. And if we will do 8 multiplied by inside the bracket 7 and 2, and it is equals to 8 multiplied by 14, and the answer is 112. So it means 8 multiplied by 7 inside the bracket multiplied by 2 is equals to 8 multiplied by inside the bracket 7 multiplied by 2. So the associative property applies to multiplication. Now the distributive property of multiplication over addition. It states that the product of a whole or natural number and the sum of two or more whole number or natural numbers grouped together is equal to the sum of products of the former numbers and each of the grouped numbers. Now we will take example and it will be clear. Now 12 multiplied by inside the bracket 3 plus 5. So it means 12 multiplied by 8, because 3 plus 5 is 8, and the answer is 96. And if you will write it in a different way, like 12 multiplied by 3 and then 12 multiplied by 5, and then we will add these two. So it will be 36 plus 60, and the answer is 96. So we can say 12 multiplied by inside the bracket 3 plus 5 equals to 12 multiplied by 3 plus 12 multiplied by 5. So distributive property of multiplication over addition is proved. Now properties of division. If a natural number or whole number is divided by another natural or whole number, the quotient may not always be a natural or whole number. For example, 72 divided by 8 is equals to 9. This is a whole number or a natural number. But 4 divided by 16 is equals to 0.25 or 1 over 4. It is not a whole number, not even a natural number. So it means closure property does not apply to division. Now we will check on commutative property on division. It is 20 divided by 4 is equals to 5. And 4 divided by 20 is equals to 1 over 5 or 0.2. It means 20 divided by 4 is not equals to 4 divided by 20. So commutative property does not apply to division. Now the whole numbers are taken in a particular order, and the quotient of the first and second number is divided by third number. The result is not the same as when the first number is divided by the quotient of second and third number. So it means we are talking about associative property. Yes, exactly. Now we can check with the help of example. 112 divided by 8, it is inside the bracket, so we will solve it first. Then divided by 2, so it is equals to 14 divided by 2. And the answer is 7. And if we will do 112 divided by inside the bracket 8 divided by 2, so it is equals to 112 divided by 4. The 4 has come from division of 8 by 2, and the answer is 28. Now we can check that both the answers are different. So it means we can say 112 divided by 8 inside the bracket divided by 2 is not equals to 112 divided by inside the bracket 8 divided by 2. So associative property does not apply to division. Now we will see what we have learned today. We did properties of addition on natural numbers and whole numbers. We learned properties of subtraction on natural numbers and whole numbers. We did properties of multiplication on natural numbers and whole numbers, and the last we did properties of division on natural numbers and whole numbers. Now I hope you can easily implement your learning on written assignments. And your written assignments are task number 1, question number 4, exercise 2B, page 29 of new countdown 6, exercise 2, task 2, question number 5, exercise 2B, page 29 of new countdown 6, and your task 3 is learn properties of four operations on natural and whole numbers. This learning will help you a lot when you will do your work in future in even other topics. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Allah Hafiz and keep practicing.